Introduce, my name is Party Rosiad. I am one of the instructors in the cement production process in Indonesia. On this occasion, we would like to share knowledge about cement technology, especially about the cement production process, starting from the raw material mining process, raw material milling process, combustion process, coal milling process, cement milling process, and cement packing process. We made this video about the cement production process to add insight and knowledge for anyone who wants to learn about the cement production process, and we made this video material into several parts sequentially. We made this video during the pandemic, which until the end of 2021 has not yet ended. Where training to several cement factories in Indonesia has not been able to be carried out offline. Hopefully these videos are useful for all of you, especially in the area of the cement production process and how to operate a cement factory in accordance with competency-based training. Before learning more about the cement production process, the first video we made was to get to know the history of the development of the cement industry, and next we will make videos that are interrelated between one process unit and another. Discussion material. 1. History of cement factory development. 2. Development of cement factory technology. 3. Types of cement production processes. 4. Technological developments to increase production capacity. 5. Cement production process flow. The history of cement development. Cement is an adhesive for building materials and has been known for centuries, as evidenced by the remains of ancient buildings that we can still see today. Like the ancient Egyptians with the relics of the pyramids, where the arrangement of rocks that are bound is strong and resistant to all weather for centuries. Likewise, the ancient Greeks and Romans with relics of ancient historical buildings. In Indonesia, the remains of ancient buildings such as the Prambanan Temple, Borobudur Temple and other ancient buildings are still standing strong. And during its construction, there was no cement factory. In 1756, an Englishman named John Smeaton discovered hydraulic lime as an adhesive for rebuilding the Eddystone Lighthouse building. 40 years later, in 1796, a man named Joseph Parker from England discovered the grains or septaria of limestone used to make hydraulic cement, which became known as Roman cement because the color is similar to or the same as ancient Roman cement. One of the relics of ancient historic buildings. This is the Colosseum in Rome, which was built in 72 BC. The ancient Egyptians used calcined gypsum or calcium sulfate as an adhesive for building construction materials. While the Greeks and Romans used limestone and silica sand heated to make mortar or building adhesive. Relics of historic buildings in Indonesia, Borobudur Temple. According to history, Borobudur Temple was built during the Buddhist Sailendra dynasty, namely during the reign of King Samaratungga, year 778-825 AD. Relics of historic buildings in Indonesia, Prambanan Temple. Prambanan Temple was built during the Hindu Sunjaya dynasty, during the reign of King Rakai Pikatan, years 850-856 AD. Technology development in cement production. In 1802, cement began to be produced in France, with limestone granules as raw materials. In 1810, Edgar Dobbs from England produced cement, with limestone and clay as raw materials. In 1813, Vicat in France, and in 1822 James Frost from England, also produced cement with the same raw materials, namely limestone and clay. In 1824, a mason from England named Joseph Aspden made a patent on a method of making artificial stone, which was eventually called Portland cement, because its hardness was similar to the rock in Portland, England. In 1825, the first cement factory was established in England by James Frost in Swascombe, then in Belgium and Germany in 1855. In 1850, David O. Saylor in Pennsylvania discovered natural cement in the form of cement rock. Natural cement is weaker than Portland cement, but still stronger than hydraulic cement. The average cement production process still uses an shaft kiln, which is shaped like a dome, with a diameter of 5 to 6 meters and a height of about 12 meters. The heat requirement for the production process is still very high, which is around 3,700 kilocalories per kilogram of clinker. In subsequent developments, several experiments were carried out by cement makers, until finally discovered by an American, the cement production process used a rotary kiln. After the discovery of the cement production process using the rotary kiln, the cement production process using the shaft kiln was increasingly abandoned and no longer developed. The difference between shaft kiln and rotary kiln is: the production capacity of shaft kiln is low, and the heat consumption is very high, or more than 3,500 kilocalories per kilogram of clinker. Meanwhile, in rotary furnaces, the production capacity can be higher, with lower heat consumption under 2,000 kilocalories per kilogram of clinker. Cement industry technology development. Portland cement factories using rotary kiln were built in America by David O. Saylor in 1871, in Japan in 1875, and followed by other countries. In line with the development of the cement production process, with the improvement of the preheating system equipment in the combustion process, the production capacity can be increased, and the heat consumption use can be lower. Clinker production capacity is currently under development, starting from 100 tons per day, 500 tons per day, 1,000 tons per day, 2,000 tons per day, 5,000 tons per day, 8,000 tons per day, and currently in 2021 the clinker production capacity has reached more than 10,000 tons per day. Cement industry development in Indonesia. In 1910, the first cement factory was built in Indonesia by the Dutch East Indies government, precisely in Indorong, Padang, West Sumatra. The first unit Semen Padang factory with a wet process production capacity of clinker 200,000 tons per year, and currently Semen Padang has 5 operating units with a capacity of 8.5 million tons of clinker per year. The wet process Indorong Unit 1 is no longer in operation. In 1957, the Gresik cement factory with a wet process capacity of clinker 250,000